I'm going to talk about wood and water. Wood and water. So I've just explained that as the water goes into the cell wall, it causes this expansion, particularly in the kind of hemicellulose and lignin region, not really where the cellulose is. And these amorphous regions, as the water molecules go in, of course they occupy space and they exert a swelling pressure on the wood, so the wood swells. And if we were to do a plot and look at the moisture content in the wood, quite often this is referred to as an equilibrium moisture content, and we look at the moisture content as water is going into the cell wall of wood, we reach a point, if we're looking at the swelling, we reach a point where that swelling stops. And what's happened here is that the cell wall of the wood is now full of water and there's no room for any more. So the water, any more water that goes into the wood will now go into the spaces between the cell walls. And this point here, which is drawn somewhat idealistically, is referred to as the fibre saturation point. In reality, if you look at any data which describes this sort of behaviour, it looks a lot more like that, and it's very hard to determine exactly where that is. So real data looks like that, and textbooks tell you it looks like that. But the fibre saturation point is often defined as being around about 30% equilibrium moisture content.